That what has to happen in here for me to see the kingdom someday is for there to be new life worked supernaturally by the Holy Spirit. That's what you said. I said, yep, that's what I think Jesus is saying. He says it again in John 6:63. Just to make sure we don't isolate this text, like it doesn't belong in the big picture of John. John 6:63. It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh is of no avail. That's John 6:63. It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh is of no avail. But, and you know this, this is now first grade John theology. You know that the Gospel of John makes something else crystal clear. Namely, that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the So Jesus is the life. Jesus is the vine. And we are the branches into which life courses like living fruit-bearing sap. And you've just told us that the Spirit gives life. So oh, I love the Gospel of John. I love the Bible. Bible takes you so far, and then it says, now do it. Do it. Think it. Figure it. Put it together. And then you start putting it together, and you see confirmations here and there. Jesus said, John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus said, John 6:35, I am the bread of life. John said, chapter 20, verse 31, these things are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and believing have life in his name. Believing have life. Believing have life. So everybody knows, because of John 3:16, that the way you have life is believing. There is no spiritual life, there is no eternal life apart from connection with Jesus. That's crystal clear in John. There is no eternal life, there is no genuine, saving, spiritual life apart from connection with Jesus. Or you could use the word union with Jesus. Christ is life. Christ is the vine. We are the branches. What happens in the new birth, therefore, I would say, is the supernatural creation of new spiritual life by the Spirit's uniting us to Jesus. That's what he does. He doesn't operate in some kind of sphere, and Jesus way over there, and he gives the life here, and then Jesus looks at, well, like that, and I'll show up and be part of that. It's not the way, you can't make sense out of the Gospel of John that way. He is life. Union with him is the source of life. When it says the Spirit does it, it means he's the agent and the one who does the uniting, just brings us into the life of Christ. So that's the objective reality of what happens. The Holy Spirit moves on you and unites you, brings you into connection with the coursing life of Jesus Christ. Now, from our side, we experience that as faith in Jesus awakened. Spiritual life and faith in Jesus come into being together. Spiritual life and faith in Jesus come into being together. The new life makes the faith possible. If you're dead, you can't believe. But since spiritual life always awakens and expresses itself in faith, there's no life without faith. Don't ever, ever contemplate someone born again and unbelieving. Don't separate these two. The work of the Spirit, uniting to Christ, bringing life that's eternal, and the faith, the receiving, the embrace, the treasuring, the trusting of Jesus over here. Don't ever separate those two. Bring those two always together. From our side, we experience union with Christ through faith. Listen to how John puts it in his letter. Oh, how the letter illumines the gospel. 1 John 5:4 goes like this. Everyone who has been born of God, so there it is, new birth. Everyone who's been born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that overcomes the world. Our faith. The key to triumph over the world is new birth. The key to triumph over the world is faith in Jesus. Because they're never separated. One is God's work. The other is our expression and experience of that work as it happens in our conscious being. We believe Him, we trust Him, we embrace Him, we enjoy Him, we know Him because we're now in Him and our life is flowing from Him. Here's another word from 1 John. 1 John 5:11 and 12. This is the testimony that God gave us eternal life, and this life is in His Son. Whoever has the Son has life. Whoever does not have the Son of God does not have life. So, if you take that, whoever has the Son has life. Whoever does not have the Son does not have life. And then you say, it is the Spirit who gives life. John 6:63. You must be born again by the Spirit into new life. You got to put these together. Who has the Son has life. To be born of the Spirit, you have life. And I put them together by saying the Spirit is the power and work and person of God, bringing our hearts together with the living Christ so that we're united with Him and there's this exploding faith out of our hearts so that we embrace Him for who He is and all the fruits of faith flow from that. Jesus is our life. Don't separate the new birth. Don't separate the new birth from Jesus. Or, closing statement, never separate two sayings from John 3. Saying number one, verse 3, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Verse 36, whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. Never separate those two. If you are born again, you'll see the kingdom. If you believe in Jesus, you'll have eternal life because the new birth brings with it and is expressed in faith. Those who genuinely believe are born again. Those who are born again genuinely believe. Let's pray. Father in heaven, I ask that from our side, faith would be granted tonight. And from God's side, faith and the new birth would be granted. I pray for those who are listening downtown, Lord's Day morning, and South Campus, Lord's Day morning, that there would be a power on these services, Lord, and that the truth of Christ, our Savior, our Lord, who loved us and gave Himself for us, would be exalted by new birth happening and faith rising in people's hearts. You are a God of free, sovereign